Hockey, the fastest game in the world, is Canada's national sport and the greatest tonic for the Blues of any sport I know of. This is the reason why Canada stands supreme in hockey. Here are a couple of future greats battling away. Look at the determination in the little fellow's efforts. What he lacks in size, he makes up for in spunk. The next stage is on the great open spaces where kids play until they're exhausted. And a pair of sore shins is just one of those things that cannot be helped. Here it is, the survival of the fittest, and the honors go to the fellow with the longest and heaviest stick. Who can tell, there may be a Marenz or Conacher here in the making. There's a comer. Look at that boy go down the right boards. Smooth, eh? Conacher, the leading goal-getter of the National Hockey League, and Howie Marenz, the Babe Ruth of hockey, two of the greatest attractions in hockey. As hockey is the king of sports, it requires an artistic setting. The new Toronto Maple Leaf Gardens, finest sport palace on the continent, is Toronto's answer to Old Man Depression. Over 15,000 have attended a single game, setting up a new indoor attendance record in Canada for any sport. This is the beginning of the battle between the two fastest and smartest teams in the National Hockey League, the Toronto Maple Leafs and Montreal Canadiens. This game ended in a tie, 1-1, after 10 minutes of overtime. The two teams were battling it out for the first place in the Canadian group. 2 points separated Canadians and the Leafs, and if the Leafs had won this game, they would have been tied. However, it ended in a tie, and they split the points. Here goes Conacher back after his man. He upset him, and the puck goes into the corner. Marenz ended up with Day in the corner, and they both hit heavily, but no one was hurt. Puck is in Canadian territory. The Canadians attempting to attack. It was broken up at center ice where the Leafs get it. Play is hovering around center ice with neither team having any apparent edge. Gracie comes over this wing to check his man, and Leduc took a long shot. Play is again in Canadian territory. Joliet at center ice with Marenz. He goes by Primo at the defense. He shoots, and Lauren Chabot made a nice stop. Another speedy attack, this time on the Toronto Nets. It ended up in the corner, and the Leafs are away again, stopped at center. Here's a bird's eye view of the whole affair, and you see these two great teams battling it out for supremacy. Andy Blair just combed somebody's head there with his stick as he ran into the defense. Canadians take their turn at attacking, and it ends up by Day. Now for the start of the second period, and look out for results. Conacher drilled one from a long way, and here goes the goal. Jackson over to Day, Day over to Conacher. Conacher let one go, it scored. And the crowd just stand up and yell their heads off. Out of the first goal of the game, Conacher getting it, with both Day and Jackson in on top of the net. That goal looked like a mountain as play continued on through the second period and then into the third period without the Canadians making any impression on the Toronto defense. When they broke through the Toronto defense, Lauren Chabot was always in the way. The Toronto kid line rush was broken up there at the Canadian blue line. Canadians quick to take advantage. Stopped at the defense, and Gracie heads down the far boards. Gracie at center ice. Goes over the Canadian blue line, a long drive. He races into the corner for it. Mantha blocks the pass out, and the play seesaws again. Marenz took one of his brilliant shots. Play is hovering around center. Close checking there by Gagne and Marenz. Gagne finally getting another on the Toronto net. Play is in Toronto territory, and the faceoff on an offside. And there they go, blinding speed as they charge in on the Toronto Nets. Here goes Bailey. He breaks away fast. Is crowded off by Lapine and checked. And the Canadians start down again into Toronto territory. Mondu being crowded into the corner. It ends up in that Canadian end of the rink. Now Canadians endeavoring to break away from the close Toronto checking at center ice. The pass is made over to this wing by Marenz. He's crowded into the corner. Tried to center it out again, but there was a spill there, and the Toronto team held tight again. Here go the Canadians, charging in again. Burke passed one to the far wing, Cotton taking it. Bailey is waiting for the pass. Cotton shoots it ahead to Bailey. Bailey carries it to center before he's checked. Now watch him go. He turns sideways there to get away from a check, and he rams into Mallinson. And the crowd seemed to enjoy that. Canadians stopped at the Toronto defense. Puck rolling into the corner. Another close call for the Toronto team. Chabot stopping a great one. There go the Leafs on the far board. Stopped at the blue line. Canadians rush right back with it. Here's a scramble, and Lauren Chabot had to come out and make a great stop. Here goes Clancy and Day. Clancy passes back to Day, then over to Clancy's. Crowd into the corner. Tried to center it out, but Canadians recover. Blair nearly got a clip on the neck there, and Finnegan of the Leafs heads down this way. Goes around one check, nearly off balance, gets the center ice. Joliet is sticking with him and took the puck and cleared it. He shoots it ahead to the far boards. Down this wing, Morenz takes the pass. He goes in, he shoots, he scored for the Canadians. Blair ended up against the boards but wasn't hurt, and that ties the old game up with less than 10 minutes to go when the Leafs seem to have it in the bag. The old Howie Morenz, the old reliable and speedy flash of the Canadian team, tied it up on a perfect pass from Gagnon. Now they're speeding away again. Morenz knocked over by Red Horner at the Toronto defense when he was nearly through. Conacher down the far wing had his backhand shot, but he was on the wrong side and couldn't click. Play still at center ice. Back checking like fiends. Lauren Chabot had to do the splits. Howie Morenz just got a bad toss, but is all right again, and they're away from the faceoff. Puck is taken at the blue line, a forward pass, and only 3 minutes to go, and the Leafs sending up another dazzling attack, trying to win that old game. There goes Primo at his blue line, center ice. He goes around one check. He ends up, though, against the defense, and that's a tough one to get by. Canadians over this wing. Mondeau's shot rolled in front of the Toronto Nets, but it's cleared. And only a minute and a half to go. Crowd are becoming really frantic now as the Toronto team bombard the Canadian Nets. It goes to the far wing. Finnegan blazes another one on the Nets. Canadians playing a man short and doing all in their power to keep the puck away. Only short time now, and the crowd are ready to jump up, and the game is over.